exports, demand, pricing?
As far as the exports are concerned, they were higher in the second half, majorly because of the sluggishness that is attributable to seasonality. So we expect they will get moderated in the second half on account of improvement in the demand that is expected.
And prices, sir, how do you expect prices to perform?
Prices are a global trend, so prices globally are stabilizing. So same trend we'll see in the even domestic market.
How has steel sector in India been impacted in light of the trade war going on between US and China?
As far as trade war is concerned, it is a worrisome because a lot of trade diversion is happening into India. So if we see in the month of August, the imports have gone up by 27%. And the proportion of 0% imports from Japan, Korea and Asian countries are 77% in the month of August. So that is a matter of concern. So when all other countries are taking steps to reduce the imports, so we are also looking forward to the government that these imports at unfair prices won't come and hit the domestic industry.
But the government has taken some measures. What more do you expect them to do? What have you been pushing for some additional measures? They have set up steel import monitoring system. They have increased some duties. What more do you expect the government to do?
Industry has been seeking to impose safeguard duty, which all other countries have done. So this is what we are really looking to. And also FTAs, where we have signed in 2009 and 2010. So they are really increasing their exports into India. If I look at first 5 months of this financial year, imports from FTA countries have gone up by 8%. So there is an increase which is happening into India that is hurting the domestic industry. So the review of FTAs and imposing safeguard duties, and while moving into RCEP as a country, we should take care that the steel is not included in those items, particularly when we are entering into with China.